What's up, everybody? We're back with some modern. Another beautiful Friday. Hey, hey. I was very excited today to play some Call Dime stuff. Could not end up getting my Valkyries in time, and they're very expensive on Moto, so I don't want to buy them. So we're playing Jund Shadow instead. It's like kind of close, I guess. We're technically closed at 8, but like I'll be here like streaming. Why, you need more kits? Did you guys finish yours already? Nice. Did you open anything good? Any money? Any Valkyries? That's a card. I want me some altar foils. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, that's a buy a box promo though. Like the buy a box promo is a foil full art. I'm assuming that card's not gonna be worth that much. I don't know what it's worth right now though. Oh, well, that's actually kind of surprising. Buy a box one's pretty cool looking too. Yeah, we'll definitely be here. It takes a couple hours at least to get this done, so Tay and I will be here if you want to stop by. We're also around tomorrow too. I might not be here tomorrow, but Tay will definitely be here. We have plenty more pre-orders to give out. Gonna be a busy weekend. You're saying you have some something spicy for us tonight? The deck list up yet? Can I peek this list? No, it's not gonna let me. It is a changeling, so technically it is a Viking. I guess the changelings are like pretty on theme for like Norse mythology. It's like they always believed that their gods could form other beings, and they were always seeing kind of stuff. I think they were just like high on mushrooms most of the time, but. All right, I'm ready to do this. Let's go. Pretty sure everyone shroomed. They all had some kind of like psychedelic something that they were doing. Pretty sure that I listened to a podcast that was talking about they're probably taking like some kind of psilocybin or something. But that was the idea of the like rage and the thought of Valhalla. It came from like a trip essentially. I've listened to
New
some like
pairing received.
Some pretty cool podcasts recently about stuff like that. Today. First up, we got Yavin. I'm assuming he is playing some kind of Eldrazi deck. Should be this one. Yeah, I have. Duncan Trussell's hilarious. He's on the Rogan podcast all the time. Like they're like good friends. He's always fun. Yes, I would like Luris. What's up, man? Oh, what I don't know what we're playing against. What has he got? Oh, he's got Lewis. Oh, is he on Shadow too? Ooh, do we have the mirror? I don't see his deck list. Yeah, alright. We'll keep this. Ooh, hammer? Yeah, okay. That's fine. These are both. This hand is good against both those decks, I think. I haven't played against hammer yet, but. Yep, okay. Do 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 do. I would think so. I'm not like really familiar with like what his deck is. Cranial Lightning seems good. Like we have so much removal. Yeah, that makes sense. So like let him equip things, make him waste his mana, kill his stuff in combat. Yep. I can see how Lurrus would be really annoying in this deck. They have so many things that they can cast. Boots. Interesting. Taking all this damage anyways. We need to find a creature. There we go. What does Guarded's Aid do? I've not played against that deck in Modern. I thought that was like a search thing, isn't it? Yes, I want an equipment so as a flash or equipment a battery so you may attach it to your feature. Yeah, that's fine. Oh, I see. Yeah, okay. So when I go to remove things, then they just switch to boots, so I need two of those. That's fine. So it doesn't have flash, does it? No, okay. Yep. I don't really have anything to do with this Lurrus yet. So what are they doing to equipped hammer? They have like other things that make it cheaper, right? Like that would make sense. Sure. Oh yeah, all the goyfs. All the goyfs. Just makes me feel so happy. Haven't played Jund in a while. First game I play, just got the triple Goyf hand. Just good old beatdowns. Although Mana Traders gave me mismatched Goyfs. That's pretty disappointing. I don't know why they did that. Come on, Mana Traders. Oh, I am mismatched Stomping Grounds too. Sad. I wonder if I have Ancient Grudge in my sideboard. With the Shadow Spear? Yeah, Shadow Spear is pretty sweet. Especially if you can get a Colossal Hammer on them. That's pretty disgusting. Oh, the Goyf. Alright, how much more removal do we have in this sideboard? Ooh, K Command seems good. I want Cause Return. Why don't it show me his deck list? Tay. Say, I can't see a deck list. Okay.
What if you go to the deck list tab on the side of the tournament? Can you see people's deck lists in there? I know that's what someone was doing last week.
Give me 1 second. I have to.
Okay,
I'm gonna run
sorry.
out of time. 7 minutes. Okay. There.
Okay. Yeah,
So Pierce
whatever, for
Ornithopter
whatever
there.
reason, but in round one, it doesn't seem to
To work,
want to
yeah.
work that well. Yeah, but you can still see them there.
Okay.
Let me know if it's still not up in round two, then I'll message me later about it.
Okay, what do we not want here? I guess the discard's probably not as good. Nazi's probably better than Kroxa. That should be. Yeah, now we just have even more. Oh, that we. I feel like that means you got to turn to something. Turn two? Come on, man, that's not. I thought you said the deck wasn't good. Second land. It's okay. Wow, I'm so bad at this. I have not played with Monastery Swiss Beer in a very long time. But I was definitely supposed to play that first. I'm so used to playing like the Rock, where like you just use your baubles to look at their deck and stuff. Oh man, good stuff. Good stuff. You have boots. Stoneforge, okay. Don't think he can. Don't think he can kill me from here. This would have been a real nice scourge, though, if I had done that prowess right. Next turn, I get to fetch and shock. I need to equip this. Yep, that's fine. I think this is how I want to do it. I just like use this Kozilek's Return first. Just potentially like make him waste his mana trying to equip something or cast something. Kill it with the Kozilek's Return. Untap, do a lot of damage to him. So we can even bolt him down to 12. This is nice. This is what we want. You have a Colossal Hammer. I think this is correct. Should be game, yeah. Okay, we have two removal spells. Yeah. There's just like way too much removal in here. Yeah, like he had the Ornithopter. The Ornithopter and the Springleaf, but not drawing another land there. It's pretty rough. The deck is, yeah. It's like any deck like that, you know, just they're gonna struggle so hard against removal. Like if they can't hit the Sigarda's Aid, then and like, essentially like, infect you, like have enough protection spells to get through your removal spells to the point where you can't actually kill it anymore. You're just not gonna be able to like grind through it. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, my hand was just a Death Shadow and two more Assassin's Trophies too. I just had all the removal. It's like I got to bring in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more removal spells. I'm already playing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 mainboard, 12 mainboard. It's a whole lot of removal. Yeah. That doesn't seem like a very good matchup. Who else we got playing now? Oh, Mr. Burkhorst is on Boggles today. Yeah. Yeah, it's like either way I get to hit like the hexproof thing or whatever. And my creature is so big at that point. I'm just saying, like, that hand was pretty nuts if I would have like done the prowess triggers properly too. Because it would have just killed you on that last turn with an extra 2 damage. And my Scourge would have been like way bigger when I played it. Yeah. Deck seems fun. Cause I haven't played Jund or Jund Shadow in like quite a while. It's the first time I've got to play with Scourge. Oh yeah, I didn't even see that you went to 5, but that makes sense. Do you find that the deck has a hard time mulliganing? Yeah. That's fair. Do you have like a mid-range plan against like other mid-range decks or decks with ton of removal? Like, is there a way for you to like shift gears into something that's like not so fragile. Right, yeah, that makes sense. Lures is a great backup plan. I really like back when I was streaming before, I really wanted to play like a Abzan Stoneforge with Lures deck. I thought that was gonna be really fun. I just never got around to building it. Yeah, are you playing what is that thing called? That human thing. The 2-mana 1/1 that's pro red black. Yeah, Oryak Champ. Yeah, that makes sense. Definitely equipping like a couple things onto that with like a Shadow Spear. Like that would definitely slow me down. It's crazy that card's been going up in price. We were actually sold out for like quite a while. Where's Aura Champion at now? Yeah, what the hell? Aura Champ's back over $20? Man, I remember when this got reprinted in Iconic Masters, it was like worthless. Craziness. You know another card like we just can't seem to keep in stock is Angel's Grace. It seems like nobody has any Angel's Graces. It got it, in Modern Masters 1, it got reprinted. I guess it's is it on the list? Is that the new list? I guess the list card's like barely made an effect on anything. I don't know. Like it could be. They did do Lotus Bloom, but we don't really know. The Steel Shaper's Gift go up too. I know that one. That one's been like expensive for uncommon for quite a while. Wow. It's like $30. What? I gotta go home and check and see if I have some Spell Shaper's Gifts. That's nuts, man. Dude, like, do we have any? I wouldn't be surprised if we just have a bunch, like a bunch of them in a box somewhere. No, we don't have any on inventory, so I'll have to go look. Yeah, it's also from like Fifth Dawn. 36. Wow. Oh, what? Somebody actually just bought us. Someone just bought all four of our Steel Shaper's gifts last Saturday for $168 after shipping. Damn. That's those magic stonks, right? That's great. I'll definitely have to check and see. I have to have some at home somewhere. Oh, everybody's done. Oh, don't get me on the GameStop thing, man. Oh my God. My last 3 days have been nothing but phone calls from clients about GameStop and like what is happening in the market. Oh. This shit is nuts. All right, you're our next pairing. Xenorifts. I do not know this person. Oh, all right. Yep. I definitely did not. Can I see a deck list this time? I cannot. Who am I playing against? Rakdos Death Shadow. All right. Kind of the mirror. We can definitely keep this. Don't know who's actually favored in this. I got Blood Moon. That's pretty gross. Don't know if Goyf is actually like a bonus. Oh, nice. Assuming if I can hit their removal, that this Goyf is actually going to be really strong. A command on top. That's not good. One, two, three, four, five. Death Shadow is going to get pretty big, but the Fatal Push just kills the Goyf. I think we want to get rid of the Fatal Push. They have K Command on top with no lands. That's pretty good for us. Like, if they dismember here, I don't really care. They're gonna get to cast Death Shadow. That also just doesn't matter. Because the big thing is that we get a creature into the graveyard. So once the creature's in the graveyard, then Gois bigger than the dismember anyways. Yep, we're fine with that. We can trade Swiss Spears. Cast that Death Shadow. Cast that Death Shadow. Come on, do it. No? Disappointing. She still has Dismember. Choose a fatal push. That's pretty good. Is he can K command here and get back a Death Shadow if he wants. Don't really care if he gets back a Death Shadow. Doesn't really do anything for him. I think we just get rid of Battle Rage. I don't think I'm trying to Battle Rage through this. Yep. So we don't want Battle Rage. Dismember's fine. Crocs is fine. Discard's fine. Just want more removal. Probably want Assassin's Trophy. If you do this more like the Jund mirror and you just like bring in shit like that, or we're even really worried about. So guys, like there's just so much removal that like Lurrus doesn't really become a thing. Or like do we want to be able to bring our creatures back? I know they have Boma Courier too. Courier. They have Angrass Rampage, Crocs of Fatal Push, Blood Moon. I think I want at least one of those. I don't want Crocs, so I feel like I'm probably never getting a chance to cast that. The 2-mana discard is probably not good. I'm happy with this. See what you got. Night's Whisper, Death Shadow. Yeah, I actually just don't want them drawing cards. Did you turn to it again? Nice. As long as we don't get Blood Mooned, we're in a pretty good spot. Do I want to protect against Blood Moon? Like, how worried are we about this? be a little bit worried. I don't think it makes sense for him to bring up Blood Moon, but I'm gonna protect myself a little bit here. True. So they do the Fatal Push. Maybe we'd really like to draw a land. Thoughtseize is pretty good. I'm assuming they take the Goyf here. Like, I can't see their. Yeah. I guess there'd be anything in their hand that they really want to protect from Thoughtseize. I think they have two cards. Their goal should really be to try and get Lurrus. Thoughtseize on top. Like, we're gonna have to Veil of Summer if he tries to take anything. We're hoping to hit a land here. Sure, he bolt us. Getting very close to death though. Thank you. Could K command. Should make him thoughtsies. You can get a Goyf back. Might be too slow. We can play Swiss Spear and kill his dude. Then he just gets that back. And his Assassin's Trophy. Yeah. It's kind of awkward. If he hits a land, gonna be pretty bad because then he can Thoughtseize and get lures back to his hand. Then he potentially can take our removal spell. Take the coin. Yeah, I think I'm okay with that. Oh, Walker is not good. Okay, so he possibly doesn't have anything, so at least gives us a turn. He's digging. That thing's pretty good. Beta push it. Beta push it. Do it. He got me. Actually, no, I don't want to take out of here. Don't really want to cut back on creatures, but I think he already has more creatures than we do. We just have to really make sure that his creatures don't survive. So we really need to hit a third land that game a little bit earlier. Assassin's Trophy. Fine with drawing that. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay, that's a 3-3, that's not very good. Go get this overgrown tomb. Play this Veil of Summer. What you got for me? Please not Bolt Fatal Push. He's thinking. See, does he have to dig? Crack this Sunbay Canyon. Croxa, ooh. Is he just going Croxa this turn? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He already had 5. He just needs to land. Then I have a 4-4. Sure. The Boggles was victorious. Take that. Ooh, baby. some good top decks. What you got for me, man? Crocs would still be pretty decent. Do you need to eat my creature? I'm a 9. Yeah, that'd be pretty rough. Could shrink my Goyf too. Or you make my Death Shadow bigger. So you have to go to like 2 though to do it. No. Yeah, Bob ain't doing it. Potentially have removal on top then. Yeah. Yeah, he has some pretty bad draws near the end. It's crazy how much more of like a mid-range deck this feels like instead of like what I remember. Wait, is Pichu here? Where's Pichu? Or is that your little like Pichu like image? Oh, nice. Oh man. Why isn't he in here? Asha. What's up, my dude? What is Asha on today? Are you on Rakdos Shadow 2? I think you are. Yes, you are. Alright. I would like to play first. Yes, I would like to have Lyris. There we go. Seems like a decent hand. We got the bets going. We need Sarah. Where is Sarah tonight? She's the gambling one. Oh, Seal of Fire. So good. What a great card. Got some Tarmogoyf food, some removal. Something to bring back with Lyris. Does that mean that you already know the result of the match? What are you more scared of here? Scourge of Goyf. Probably Scourge, right? Yeah. Esker's gonna be pretty big this turn. I think it probably doesn't matter. Whatever I do play is gonna die. I don't actually like really need to hurt myself here. I'm just gonna get a forest. Have you guys got to play much Kaldheim yet? Do any drafts or anything? We will grab Lurus. Hope he doesn't have a Thoughtseize. It's okay, we still have removal and a Peatland. That's a big dash out of him. Man, we are not drawing well here. Yep. We need to draw something quick. He doesn't really have to do anything from here now. That was unfortunate. We got really, really flooded there. Pretty good shape there. We do like 3-4 lands. Key command trophy. Yeah, Swiss spear. Croxa. Battle rage. So we needed him to not have that second Thoughtseize. Because if it was removal, we at least would have got to cast something out of that. It may not have mattered anyways, but at least get some kind of value off the Lurus. Nice, that'd be fun. I started doing a draft like earlier today, but I didn't really know what any of the cards were. My deck's not very good. I'll have to go like read over like one of the archetype things, see what people are actually playing. I guess it really depends on what you're trying to do. Like Moto can be an actual investment where like Arena is really just entertainment. Keep this. That seems pretty good. Yeah, that's. Don't know how much I trust what they're actually saying and what they're gonna do. They seem to change their mind all the time. Oh, do you have a way of stopping me from killing this? Maybe he was hoping that I would just, like, fuck that up somehow. Do it backwards. Want this one down. Oh, we take the Night's Whisper. And we can protect this. You turned one him? Oh man. You said this deck wasn't good, man. You lied. You lied to us.
It was
Was it
bad.
you? You did
It
it to
was me. I
you?
got turn one Ulamog.
That's messed up, man. That's so messed up. How can you do that, Chris? To find an answer this quick. Guess I can do that. Doesn't feel great. That's gross. Yep. It's only 11. 9 would be a 4-4. If I don't get this back, I'm in a lot of trouble though. So I put myself at 9. That's a pretty good draw. A little bit of even battlefield again. He could put Lyris in his hand. It's not in his hand yet. Of me. Also fine. You just make my death shadow bigger. Be able to get me here. There's like a bunch of stuff that I'm dead to now. Is that a bolt? That's just a bad attack if he doesn't have bolt. He just loses his Kroxa. We discard Lurrus, then I just can't attack. I'm gonna risk it. If he has bolt, he has bolt. But he's got to have something. like, what do you possibly have? Or whatever it is, you have to cast it. I feel like you probably just want to put Lurrus in your hand here. And potentially Bulmucker next turn with the Lurrus. K command. Yeah, sure. God, I actually can't kill him. That's so frustrating. I need like anything but a land there. Oh no, I'm just dead. I need your land, now you can proc me. Yep. That's frustrating. That sucks. I don't think there's much other than like him making me discard my Lurrus there that can do anything. So it would have still been at 3. I guess I'd possibly still just die to not having a card there. He just gets to cast the Croxa again. I didn't think Croxa was actually gonna be that good in this matchup. Maybe I should have just kept mine in. Or just late game, it just gives you another win con. We still got left. Yeah, some more games. Okay. I will be right back. We're back. Just waiting on two more matches. Howard versus Dredge and Death Shadow versus Orzhov Gumbo. Alright, so that's hammer time. Isn't it just your deck? Everything else seems pretty normal. There's a bunch of Death Shadow. Where's this list? I'm gonna check this out. Where are you, Chris Haw? Four color Eldrazi. Wow. What the hell? He's playing all the Eldrazi? I'm eating. I got some cashews, some almonds, some walnuts. Bunch of healthy stuff. Brilliant Ultimatum? Oh, you have Omniscience too. What the hell? What is this nonsense? Is this deck getting banned? I know he doesn't, that's why I'm eating it. At least it's like this deck looks like super expensive. So if people wanna buy this deck, you can go right over to ChimeraGamingOnline.com. You can purchase all these really expensive cards. Imagine this foiled out. Oh my god. Get those foil City of Brass. Oh man. Are you just like OG City of Brass? Nice. What's Tendo at? How do you spell it? No, it was just Tendo Ice Bridge. Oh, it's not even. What? It's nothing. It's like worthless. It could like 15, 16 bucks? No problem. It is single printing. And from Kamigawa Block. You gotta do show me the real City of Brass. Quit playing games, TCG. This bad boy right here. Oh yeah. I think I have. I know I have one of these ones foil. I think I have one of these ones foil though. Might be like an 8th edition one. That's pretty wild. So expensive. Although I found one of these today. Oh yeah, baby. That's money. You want to talk GameStop, baby? We're on that Wheel of Fortune life. Reserve list. I'm actually legit running out of water. Oh, nope. Oh, wow. We're good. Don't know, man. GameStop's got money now. We'll see what happens Monday. I'm pretty sure they're still up right now. After hours is only down 13 bucks. Insanity. Absolute insanity. Hey man, clearly the games were worth less than $4. They couldn't even make a profit on that. Yavin, you gotta believe in the heart of the cards, man. Leave them to the top of the deck and they will be there for you. There's the other one that was going wild today. Everybody's talking about. It's the second most shorted stock on the market right now. Delicious. It's time. Who am I playing against? Brayden. Let's do this, man. This might actually be a really tough one. I would like Luris. Yeah, this seems all right. It's not great. They don't actually do that much damage to themselves. This might actually be really bad. I might not be able to get this Scourge to be very high. Yep. Not bad. It's the Meba and the Loam. And the Conflagrate and a Golgaritha. Right on. Oh. I am very glad he did not hit those amalgams off that too. Interesting. I don't know what he really wanted to get into his Gregor from there. So we can go black, red, and I have to go black, green too. We have a plan. Man, creeping chill. That is nasty. It's all on you, Mr. Death Shadow. You can do two. Can only do three damage. Might be able to do this. Yep, that's fine. These things come into play. Tabs, yes they do. You have one card. That's 20 there already, so we don't have to do that. Kill this thing real quick. Then we battle rage. Oh yeah. Wagon. Go to combat. Go to attack. It just seems like a lot of hate. If you don't care to have thought seize. This caller's return can kind of clean things up. You probably don't want dismembers. Battle rage is fine. I don't know what cause return either though. Eh, maybe it's fine. We'll try it. We need a decent amount of graveyard hate. So if we can surgical the prized amalgams, then Kozilek's return pretty much kills everything else. Yeah, this is good. Always keep a surgical hand. No problem. Remember when I was playing like Abzan, Traverse, back when KCI was a thing, and my sideboard was just like four surgicals. Those are good times. Yep, yep. I want to. I don't think so. I think I can wait till next turn. Yeah, I don't care about an Archimeva. What are the chances that he just has Cathartic Reunion though, and we just want to get rid of the Cathartic Reunion? Draw off that, which I think is fine. Another Scourge. Scourge actually doesn't really seem that good in this matchup. It's a real feel bad if they just hit Creeping Chills and kill it. Blood Gas, I don't really care about. The more damage he does me, the easier I can get these Death Shadows out. It's awkward. So it looks like he has a really slow hand, so it's not gonna matter. This one could be bad. I think I have to play against Nargamiba. Fox 2. He's gonna get Rising Malcolm off that. Do I have to worry about Conflagrate here? it's fine if he does that. I don't really care about that. Ox could also be a big problem here, though. I think I just want to hit the prize amalgams. I don't want him getting any other free. Wait, somebody was playing the mirror? Does he only have three? Interesting. Love to hit a land here. There we go. Oh, he does have four cards. That's all real bad. I guess we take alone. No, this is game two. I won game one. I battle raged him for like 22. Okay, so that Mesa's conflagrate can't kill those Death Shadow. And if he can kill us with Ox, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. We need to hit two more Creeping Shells. But we're also gonna need to hit Battle Rage to be able to do anything. I only have a couple. Just to hit like Cathartic Reunion and stuff. Come on, no Creeping Chill. No Creeping Chill. Damn it. So I think he needs a not attack. He needs a not attack, and then either try and Creeping Chill me into Conflagrate next turn. Yep. Ooh. How many Conflagrates? You have two Conflagrates. Two black ash, two fire grates. I think there's two of everything. There's not much I can do there. Five, six, seven. What is 05? And hold back one, I think. No, because then he just blocks that. Like, we still just need to hit Battle Rage to be able to win this. Take three, we're gonna go to two, we're gonna have 2 10-tons. We have 4 cards. Damn it, I needed to actually do that before he cast a conflagrate. I need to put a stop there. Yeah. Oops. What was our next card? Was it Battle Rage? It was not Battle Rage. It didn't matter. Okay. Yeah, like Cake Man and Assassin's Trophy are like pretty average. Like, I took out the Thoughtseize, so I'm not taking any extra damage. But sometimes you can hit something that's like pretty relevant. I have Graveyard Hate here though. I really don't like having Graveyard Hate, but was this hand any better than the last one? I get to draw an extra card. Turn 2 Goyf. No, there's no way. Yeah, this is better. Yeah, it's possible. It's like the first mulligan is like, if you just hit a hand that has like a, I don't know, a creature, a discard, or a creature and some kind of hate, like, that's usually gonna be better. It's also possible that you go like, look at his hand, he doesn't have anything like good to take away from it. Play a Goyf, like start attacking, he goes off, puts a couple creatures in the battlefield, and then like he just overruns from there. Whereas if he has a slow hand here, to. That's annoying. All the Titan players didn't show up today. To hit a land there, especially like a fetch land, would have been really good. He's potentially stuck on mana though. All right. Interesting. So we need to take the Stinkweed Imp. He taps for zero? Wait, why did he taps for zero? Oh shit. Wow, am I gonna fucking die because of this? Did he make a mistake and then I'm gonna be punished? No. Oh wait, does Creeping Chill not go off? Yeah, more question like why did he chalice? Why did he chalice on zero? No, he meant to cast it for one, yeah. He definitely did. He just said it in chat. But what about the Creeping Chill? Did the Creeping Chill not cast because of that then? Because he has chalice on zero now? Oh, you have to. So he just missed that too then? Ooh, that was a good draw. Oh, no, it was. Oh, yeah, it is. Yep. Yeah, that's what I thought too. It just seems weird that he messed up the chalice and then also forgot to do the creeping chill. Like it's always possible, but so maybe casting ox here. Yeah. I'm assuming he's doing ox. Billy's prize amalgam triggers. assuming 3, 6, 9. He's also just played Goyf here. Just block with Narc Amoeba. And I can't deal with that though. He has a 3. Need to shock here, so I'm going to 9. We're gonna kill those things, and then we can take 6 and block that. We just have to block with everything. Maybe I don't need green. No, because then that dies. That's gonna die too. Oh man. I guess it just depends on what he's got here then. No, because he has Conflag, right? I'm just dead to Conflag. Or not? Did he pass through his turn? So yeah, my opponent just misclicked, or I guess he yielded through his turn, but he had like a flag, so I just conceded to him. He had exactly the three cards I needed him. I needed to just be like one life ahead. But that was tight. Tight, tight games. Thought I could almost pull it off there. I guess I could have fetched for a basic instead, and that actually would have been okay. Because he only would have been able to conflag me. Yeah, I don't know. It was tight. Deck was fun today. It's been a while since I played Jund. Hopefully, by next week we'll be able to play Valky. You can play some real Jund. I ended up going 2-2. Yeah, the real Jund. I've it prepped and ready to go on my mana traders. It's not really playable because it's on the backside, right? Unless you actually cast that card on the Tibalt side, I'm gonna say Tibalt's still not playable. When you get to cast it for free, then it's okay. Aw, yeah. Bloodbraid's a real champ, the real hero. Yeah, I was really excited today. I prepped it like early this morning. I got my mana traders thing ready. I was like, all right, got my sideboard ready. LSV put out an article about it. I was so hyped. But one more week. Oh, we'll get to do the thing. Yeah, like, so legit. Is this card gonna get banned then? Like, is this deck busted? But how do you stop it? I appreciate it. I don't have Sarah here keeping me hydrated. Oh, just a counterspell. So it's just bad against control decks? I guess. If you can dodge the control decks, then you just win. If you can turn one it, you win. A lot of times you turn two it on the play, you win. Yeah, of course, right? You just gotta cast the Emrakul. Yeah, all right, we're playing Legacy now. Force check. Do I win? Turn one, do I win? But I guess against the control decks, they're just bringing in what is it called? That white dude, the Chancellor. I just put my deck back to Mana Traders. If you mean, do you want to play like, I'll just put some cards together and then you can turn to me? You're saying, let me see if I might actually own a deck. I might own a deck still. Give me a second. Titan would be a terrible matchup. Let's see. Ooh, we got blue-white Stoneblade. That's gotta be a favorable matchup for me. All right, let's do this. Where are you at? On the play. And all his creatures like protection from shit too, or indestructible. I guess path is probably fine. We'll get rid of this. Oh wow, he's got the caverns too. Oh my god. All right, we gotta hit the force negation. That's not helpful. Well, Spellcaller would be all right. Let's take the land. Oh no, I'm not gonna be able to do that. Bottom. Forgot what spell I was casting. What nonsense. What is this bullshit? Is ridiculous. What does this thing do? Annihilator 4? We're just dead. Well, Spellcaller, I don't think you're doing anything. You playing like Ardent Plea? Oh my god, he's in it. My God. Wait, why didn't it cast? Oh, dude. Oh, why did I? Well, I was confused, and now we're gonna die because of it. just sacked a land for no reason. Now we're dead. I guess, like, he still has to do something. He might just have, like, a bunch of spells that do nothing. That he does. Alright. We're back in the game. Come on. Aw, yeah. Oh, we're good. We can't lose now. We can't lose now. Bottom that. Yeah, this game's over. We can spell scenarios to bolt trickery. We're gonna be able to spell queller shit. We can path whatever creature he gets out. What are you casting? Sure. Another one? Oh, God. So he's got Pray, no Emrakul, right? Yeah, that's fine. This thing doesn't even do anything. This card's bad. It's really unfortunate that we drew a Field of Ruin. Come on, don't do it again. Come on. Come on. All right, here it is. The Simian Spirit Beats. What? I didn't realize I was actually at two. Oh, I guess he just can't beat Teferi, right? Unless he has it right now, which he discarded. I'm gonna put money on he doesn't have it right now. We're gonna go for this. Pretty sure that means we win. Yeah. I asked him if we win, he said he has to monkey me now. Alright, we did it. Deck can't beat Teferi. Ooh, nice draw. What do we want to do is backwards. Cast this. We'll get Batterskull. Cast Serum Visions. Put a land on top. Put on bottom. What is the cheapest Eldrazi cost? Like 10? Sorry, we still got some time. Oh, with the Teferi? Yeah, I definitely don't get to do that enough to like actually think about it. So I wasn't really playing Serum Visions in a lot of the decks that I was playing Teferi in. Yep, do this. We have a Batterskull. Alright, so everybody knows for next week that if Chris is playing this is how you beat him. You build Sharkblade or some kind of Stoneblade deck. Four Teferis every deck next week. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. It's getting close. Gotta hit something this turn, otherwise we got him. But he hit an Emrakul. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. No, Emrakul was like what, 13 or something? Ooh, he has Omniscience. You're just casting nothing. You're just dealing damage to yourself. I don't think so. Yeah. Okay. Like, rest in peace can stop him from continuing. Stroke is okay. Cleek is probably not that great, but Speller's fine. Path is good. We just don't want rest in peace then. Do we not want Ashiok then? I think Ashiok actually doesn't do anything either. He's not really searching his deck. Why is there only two Teferis in this deck? Oh god. That's a problem. Guess we need the Mystical Disputes. One Stoneforge. Yeah, okay. We'll try that. Try this. This might be too slow. Guess it like really depends on what he hits. Guess he does have to have monkey too. He might just not have that. I'm gonna Snapcaster because I can still Spell Snare if he had something there, but I want to start attacking him. Just put some pressure. So if he's not gonna do anything, we'll just kill him in 10 turns. He's actually got like nothing. So he could be setting up. Like multiple things, I guess. He just said the CMC of his hand is 53. We go. I feel like this deck probably gonna have like a near impossible time beating a control deck. Like he can try and go off here. Yeah. But We have the spell snare. I don't know. Xavier's moving at like 1.
Right.
So I want to be there at least for that. But depending on what time I wake up, I might just come in the morning and then I'll just head out for 1. And
yeah.
I don't know how long I'm going to be, so.
I'll be here out there. So.
Cool.
Doing deliveries and then. I don't know if you saw, but Mitch Watson came by, traded in what he got in his last kits and then picked up some more.
Yeah.
He was like, hey, I'm coming to pick up kits. This was at like 8:57. I was like when? He was like,
now.
Right now, 30 to 40 minutes. I was like, I'm going to be gone, man.
Yeah,
and he was like, 20 minutes. And I was like, you better hurry.
Yeah.
And then he was like, Bill Adele almost flipped the car turning the last corner. We'll be there soon. So that was pretty good. Alright, I'll talk to you later.
Yeah, see you, man. Yeah, so all you need is some counter spells. Spell snare. Clutch. Yeah, and I missed using my path before you attacked a second time, so I just sacrificed one of my lands for no reason with the Annihilator trigger. It's like, oh my god, no, we've definitely lost now. But that is pretty wild, man. Like that deck is nuts. Like there's not many decks that could actually handle that. Also, like if you just would have hit like Emrakul instead, I was dead. Cause then I can't path it, and then yeah. Yeah, that's wild. Right. Yeah, that makes sense too. This seems more fun though. I like random Eldrazi time. You just never know what one I'm gonna kill you with. Because people get annoyed when they just get killed in Emrakul all the time, right? True. Oh, man. Alright, well, I'm going to get out of here. It's been a long, long day. And I got to get up early in the morning. Got all this pre-release stuff to do. So, we will be back next week. At least for Friday. We'll see about maybe Tuesday or something. So, thanks for coming out, guys, and I'll see you later.